In this session, let's learn about roles. What are roles? A group of privileges make up a role. That's all. You are taking a bunch of privileges and then grouping them together. Why do you need that? Obviously, it is used for easy privilege management. Okay, suppose example, if you have to give various privileges to the users, you can say grant select insert on customer table to this user, grant delete on sales table to this user. So like that, randomly you can give privileges across your organization. If you do that way, managing the privileges will be really tough. Instead of that, if we combine a set of privileges and give it to the users, that would be good, right? Example, let's say in our organization, we have managers and operations people, okay? A manager requires insert, update, delete on a sales history table, and also he requires a create table privilege. So we can take these two privileges and then create a role and assign this role to all the managers in your organization. In this way, you can say all the managers in the organization gets the manager underscore role. Cool, right? Now when it comes to the operations, they require an insert and an update on the sales table, and they require an insert and update on the product table. So you combine these two privileges into the role called operations role, and now you give this operations role to all the users who are working in the operations department. Like this, depending upon the roles in your organization or the responsibilities in your organization, you can create a role and combine a bunch of privileges into that role and then assign that role to the users. That's a cool idea, right? Yes. And one more thing is, like, not only privileges can be combined as a role, even you can include another rule into a role. Okay, you see, the operations role is made up of insert update on sales and insert update on product. So now this operations role is given to the role manager role. That means this manager role has all these four privileges. That means Peter, who has a manager role, has all these four privileges, and John and Tom, who has an operations role, has these two privileges. Okay? And creation of a role is very easy. It can be as simple as create role, role name, or if you want to make it secure, you can say create role, role name, and identified by password. Okay? And based on the example, we came up with these are the various steps to follow. So first you create a manager role, and then you give insert, update, delete on sales history table to manager role, and then you grant create table to this manager role, and then assign this manager role to Peter. In the same way, on the operations role, you create the role operations role, grant insert update on sales table to the operations role, grant insert update on product table to operations role, and then grant operations role to manager role. You see, we are assigning the operations role to manager role, and then finally we are assigning the operations role to John and operations role to Tom. So these are the various steps, and in the next session we will use this exercise to perform the demo. Okay.